Hi, I'm John from the bada team at Samsung Mobile. Welcome to part 2 of our introduction to security in bada applications. This video is one of a series that introduce various topics that should help get you up to speed with bada. Make sure you check out our blog at developer.bada.com or watch security part 1 and the rest of our videos on YouTube. In part 1 we introduced bada security classes and showed you how to use public-private key encryption. In part 2, we'll explain how to use digital signatures and hashes. We'll extend the Alice and Bob example and walk you through code that demonstrates these security features. Let's kick off with signatures, which are used in bada to verify the sender of a message.
So it's easy to fake a message?
Bob and Alice think their messages are secure, but they didn't bargain for the efforts of Eve, or will stop at nothing to read the contents of their messages. Eve has worked out how to intercept communication between Alice and Bob and uses her skills at faking sender information to carry out what's termed a man-in-the-middle attack.
How does a man-in-the-middle attack work?
Bob sends his public key to Alice, but Eve intercepts it and will use it to impersonate Bob. Eve sends her own public key to Alice, pretending to be Bob. Alice thinks she sends a message to Bob, encrypted with what she thinks is Bob's public key, but we know is actually Eve's public key. Now Eve intercepts this message, decrypts it with her private key, reads the contents, makes the subtle change, re-encrypts the message with Bob's public key, and sends the message to Bob, making it look as though the message originated from Alice.
Do Alice and Bob know their messages have been intercepted?
Neither Alice nor Bob know that their messages have been intercepted by Eve.
How do you use digital signatures to verify senders?
When Alice sends a message to Bob, she signs it with her private key and a digital signature. Only Alice can know her private key, so if the message signature is verified using Alice's public key and signature, then the message can only have come from Alice.
Can Eve still intercept the messages?
Eve may still be able to intercept the messages, but she can't impersonate Alice or Bob, since any message she sends will fail the signature verification, since she doesn't have Alice's private key.
How are signatures implemented in bada?
Signatures in bada are implemented by the RSA signature class, which is part of the security crypto namespace. In our example, the signMessage method of Alice form is responsible for signing the encrypted message to be sent to Bob. For demonstration, Alice's signature is very, very simple, but as we'll see later, the signature in a full application will be more complex. SigBuffer is the byte buffer containing Alice's signature. Flip is a method of byte buffer which resets the buffer so it's ready for us to use. We create a new RSA signature object and call the setPrivateKey method to associate this signature with Alice's private key. Then we call signN, passing in the signature buffer. SignN returns an encrypted version of the signature, which we send to Bob along with the message.
How can Bob check that the message includes Alice's signature?
When Bob receives the message, he checks the signature by creating a new RSA signature object, setting its public key to Alice's public key, and calling the verify method to check that the encrypted version of Alice's signature matches the signature set up in SigBuffer. If the signature was not generated from Alice's private key, or the signature does not match, then the verification will fail, and Bob cannot verify that the message came from Alice.
Could Eve sign a message pretending to be Alice or Bob?
There's no chance for Eve to send a message pretending to be Alice or Bob, because she doesn't have access to their private keys, so she can't sign the messages.
Okay, so John, what are we going to look at towards the end of this piece?
Well, last but not least, we'll take a look at hashes, and these are used in bada to check that the contents of a message have not been tampered with.
Bob and Alice generate a hash value, also known as a message digest, from the content of the message. This digest is generated using a cryptographic hash function. You can think of a digest like a fingerprint, generated from a block of data, in this case our message. It's generated in such a way that it's not possible to generate the original message from the digest, and extremely unlikely for the same digest to be generated from different messages.
How is the message digest calculated?
A mathematical algorithm is used for this that creates a pattern that's unique for the content. When the message is received, the same algorithm is used on the receiver's side. The receiver compares the digest generated from the sent message with the digest calculated from the message as it is received. If the digests match, then the message has not been tampered with.
How are hashes implemented in bada?
The classes for implementing cryptographic hash functions are all part of the security crypto namespace and implement the interface defined by iHash. The MD5 hash, SHA1 hash, and SHA2 hash classes represent the different algorithms that are used to generate a digest. Now let's see some code. In the Alice form, we use the signWithHash method to generate a digital signature from the message digest. This signature is then sent to Bob along with the message itself. First, we create a new RSA signature object and set it up to use Alice's private key. Then we create a new hash object and call the getHashN method to generate a digest from our message. We then pass this on to the signN method of the RSA signature class. This method returns the signature of the message digest, which we store as a byte buffer, psignature, and send it along to Bob with the message.
Does signN change the contents of the digest?
SignN doesn't change the contents of the digest, it just returns its digital signature.
How does Bob check that the message from Alice has not been tampered with?
When Bob receives the message, first he decrypts it using Alice's public key and stores the result in pmessage. The BobForm method verifySignedWithHash is then called to verify that the message has not been tampered with. We start with creating a new RSA signature object and set it up to use Alice's public key. Then we create a new hash object and generate a message digest from the message received and decrypted. The verify method is then called to ensure that the signature of the digest we have just generated matches the signature sent to us as part of the message. If the verification succeeds, then we know that the message was signed with Alice's private key and has not been tampered with. If verify returns false, then either the message has been altered or Alice cannot be verified as the sender of the message. The reason why we generate a signature from the message digest rather than the message itself is that generating a signature from the entire message would take a huge amount of time to compute, especially on a resource-limited device such as the mobile phone. Let's take another look at our project in action and see how Alice and Bob ensure the integrity of the messages they exchange. For this, we run our demonstration app and use a more advanced version of the Alice and Bob forms. In the Alice form, we enter a message. We click Encrypt to encrypt the message and generate a signature from the message hash to ensure that we know if the message has been tampered with. Over at Bob form, Bob receives the message. He decrypts it using his private key and verifies it using Alice's public key and the signature of the hash message. The message is verified. It was sent by Alice and the message hash is correct. The message has not been tampered with.
So at this stage, the verification would fail if Eve had tampered with the message.
Let's take a look at what happens when Eve manages to intercept the message. In the Alice form, we type in the message to Bob. But to see what happens when Eve intercepts the message, we click the Eve intercept button. In the Eve form, we make a change to the message and set it on to Bob. Bob decrypts it and attempts to verify the message, but verification fails.
Why did it fail?
Verification failed for two reasons. Eve does not have access to Alice's private key and cannot sign the message. In addition, the message has been modified, so the hash generated from the original message will not match the hash generated from the decrypted message. Bob knows that the message cannot be trusted, and Bob and Alice's security strategy has been successful.
Okay, so John, where can I find out more about security in Bada?
Well, keep an eye on developer.bada.com. You'll find videos, recipes, and technical documentation.